Hi guys, this is Rusty 78609 in Central Texas, USA. I'm glad to be here. Fellow humans. The sun hadn't quite creeped up yet. It's a little early, but it's like, hey Google, how's my day?
Hi, Rusty. It is 6:12 a.m. Right now in 78611, it's 76 and mostly cloudy. Today, it'll be partly cloudy, with a forecasted high of 97 and a low of 71. Have a nice day.
Okay. Hey, Google, tell us a joke.
As a golfer, it's always smart to wear two pairs of pants. You know, in case you get a hole in one.
It's crazy, isn't it? What the hell does that mean? I don't know. Anyway, enough said. What else? Oh, yesterday was tough getting videos up, man. I don't know what YouTube was doing, but it took me forever to get comment call loaded. But anyway, maybe we won't have that problem today. That was yesterday, and yesterday's gone. Nothing I can do about that. Hey, Google, what's the temperature in Capitan, New Mexico?
The current temperature in Capitan is 62 degrees Fahrenheit.
Hey, Google, what's the current temperature in Kingsland, Texas?
In Kingsland right now, it's 76 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay. Yeah, the high today is supposed to be about 98, I think, or 96. But anyway, that's the way it goes in Texas. I've been here for many, 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 many years, and that's the way it is. But anyway, so we're going to do comment call today, and then we'll do what else? I may go to the RV dealer and burn it and see if they've got anything new in. If they have, I'll do some of that. But anyway, Brenda Coetta says that is bizarre about one leg of the RV being bent. Yeah, it is, but you know, there's nothing I can do about it. You know, it's what it is, you know. I mean, it's done. Pamela Chandler, so glad you're safely home. Rest up now and trim the weeds. Yeah, I will. Yeah, you know, the deal on the weed eater that the individual was going to send me kind of fell through because the shipping on it was going to be $75 or some crap. And I just said forget the whole thing and I'll order one. So I did. I ordered one. I think it was a Black & Decker. Had came with extra battery and stuff, charger. So it's okay. I mean, I don't need a great one. But anyway, it's supposed to be here like Friday, I think. Rick S., it says it was shipped UPS ground, not bad at all. I expected to see trees growing out of the driveway. How many miles did you drive on this excursion? Oh, I don't know. Round numbers, 2,000. You know, overall, you know, going back and forth and stuff. Me, my cat, and I am glad you're back safely at the home base. Me too. Deborah Fry says, nice piece, little piece of land. Thank you. Whatever happened to Rondlin 100? I don't know. I think she's on a trip. I don't know what happened to her. People come and go on this channel, guys. Here I am in my Fruit of the Loom t-shirt, but that's all you need in Texas, I promise you. Patricia Oaks, lovely to be home. So pleased all went well on your adventure. Now relax, you got it. Now time to relax. Roger St. Martin, no comment call today. No, it was there, I just couldn't get it loaded. Everything's okay. Home base looks like it did when you left it. Now you need a vacation from your vacation. Rocky the Rock, such an inspiration. I hate being single now, and it's hard to be happy with what's happened in the past that made me single, but you are sure inspiring me to look forward to the future, and you can be single and enjoy life too. I would say I've been doing it for 30 years, and I've enjoyed it more, I think. Thank you, Rocky. God bless. Peace. Yeah, you know, the sound of one hand clapping is not all bad, folks. It's up to you. It's your choice. If you're not comfortable in your own skin, guess whose fault it is? Yours. Don't blame anybody else. Rick and Amy Clark, glad you made it home safely. I can understand now why you got homesick. All that privacy and those nice views must have been calling your name. Have a good night, Rusty. Yeah, it is nice here. There's no doubt. It's hard to beat this when I'm traveling. Rocky the Rock, you need a weed eater for all that. I guess I'm going to get one. Van and Halen, make sure you don't have anything private written on that wall. This new camera people are going to be able to read whatever you hang there. Yeah, that's true. I don't care. Hell, let them read it. You know, this is crap. Anyway, now you got me thinking about it. Charlie, I live on a spring-fed lake in southwest Michigan. Makes me appreciate the fact that it always stays the same level. Would be a bummer if I couldn't put my jet ski and pontoon boat in because of low water level. Yeah, the San Angelo State Park Lake Ivy is really low. Papa bless my boy Rusty. Do you smoke gas? If not, give it a try sometimes. Much better than alcohol. No, I don't smoke gas, and I've been doing beer for so long, I ain't changed. I enjoy drinking my beer. I look forward to that. Lizzie Davis, what's in the box? It turns out what it was a return thing for the TDS modem that I had when I was in Capitan. Donna Griggs, glad you made it home safe. Looks like someone backed up to the pole. I don't know what happened to the pole. Whatever it is, bent. Doesn't bother me. 5 cents. I'm just glad that's all it was. This is on the Dometic CF-18, John Henry. Boy, the price of these has gone through the roof. They're now $493 on Amazon. Anyone seen them cheaper anywhere? Thanks for the great video. Yeah, the Dometic CF-18s have gone up. I think it has something to do with the compressors. They're having a hard time. Jimbo left about 10 reasons why that pole is bent. Someone parked under the carport and their mirror caught the post. It's possible. I'm not worried about it. Arthur Leslie, now that you've had a chance to really check out the new trailer, any regrets on your choice of size or model? No. The one thing that I wish I had, and you can't hardly get it in any RVs, not only this one but others, it would be like a full bathtub. That would be nice. But I've lived without it for 20 years, so I'm not 25 years. I'm not worried about it now. Easy Smoker 539 looks like a nice, quiet place. Roundup, man's best friend. Can be, but that stuff's dangerous, man. This is Gene Jones. That noise you hear is my air conditioner up there. Gene Jones, camping always makes me love my home. Nice leaving, but best getting back. Nice to see you home, Rusty. Thank you, Gene. G-E-A-N, Gene. Donna McKee, your home base is awesome. Love your cover for Arrow. I know it makes a huge difference in a lot of ways. Good idea for my future. How is it secured down? They use what are called mobile home ties or screw down things. I got four of them, one on each corner. They're $50 extra a piece, but you know, they're worth it. Yeah, they screw in the ground about 18 inches, and yeah, they'll hold. Bernie O'Show, what size is the cover? 18 by 26. I need that exact same thing. Can you remember? Yeah, it's 18 by 26, and I've got 9-foot legs because it's the point goes up 2.5 feet above the leg, so that the peak would be 11.5 feet if the legs are 9 feet. And you need that much clearance. You could go to 10 if you wanted more clearance. Mabel Lane, looks like a hammer hit the pole to bend it. I don't have any clue. I don't know. Michael Warren, aluminum over your door window. What does it do beside block the view? I don't know. I guess it just blocks the view, Michael. I'm not sure what you're talking about. The aluminum over your door window. I'm not sure, dude. You missed me on that one. Stephen Clint, thanks for the great, interesting trip, Rusty. We saw some awesome scenery, had farm fresh eggs for breakfast. Yeah, I did. I still got them. A few of them. Took a bike ride with a wonderful young lady and met fine people. You are the king of camping, no doubt about that. I don't know about the king of camping, but I did have an interesting, varied experience, and that's what I like. Lou D, get a used MyPod for short trips. Okay, whatever that is. I know what you're saying. Yeah, that's a good idea. Mike Butterfield, I can go if a MyPod wouldn't work for me, but I got the back of my truck with a camper top. I'd just soon do that. Mike Butterfield, your son really did wonders with the place. Papa Rusty, yeah, he did. He cleaned it up. Bob B, Could it have been an animal running through that bent your support? No, those supports are really sturdy. No, a deer would have just knocked itself out and still been there. Tracy Phillips, great comment call today. Rusty mosquitoes in South Arkansas will carry you off. Glad I don't live around rice fields anymore. Here in my hometown now, south of Fort Smith, no trouble with mosquitoes. But yeah, mosquitoes can really get to you anywhere, even camping out anywhere. Larry Carr, my home base, aliens visited your home base after your tour of the museum. They may have bent the post with their flying saucer. Glad you made it home, big guy. Me too. Yeah, it was a good trip. Linda Fowler, we've been waiting for you, Rusty. Always good to hear, see you. Carl says hi from one Texican to another. Well, hello, Carl. Larry Carr probably needed a windsock to direct them when leaving. Yeah, well, I've got a windsock and I may put it up this week. Ann Blades, I was going to check out your service and see if they offered it in Oklahoma. I hope the service and the hotspot you have is all you need. Well, if you're talking about the Verizon service, I'm sure they do. If you're talking about TDS, the cable, I don't know. John Denver, back home again. Yeah, that was a good one. PJ Bikerville left a link to John Denver's song, Back Home Again. Master Sergeant Jim, little skeeters in Texas. I don't believe it. Everything is big in Texas, or so I've been told. Don't believe everything you've been told. We got some right here in Central Texas that are no bigger than gnats, and they'll drive you nuts. Unfortunately, we don't have many because it's so dry here. Sharon Nichols got a long comment. I'll read part of it. Yep, agree with all you've said. This is home. We made it. Welcome back to home. North Texas is hot, but like you said, it's home. That's what AC and pools are for, right? I don't have a pool, but I got an AC. I'm currently looking into tiny houses, an RV camper living, not a new fancy camper RV, but one that's big enough for a small family. I didn't see your Amazon link, but I'll definitely look for it. Well, it's in the description of the video, so I do hope that we get some rain. The Amazon link's in the description of the video, and for those of you that have used it, I appreciate it very much. Thank you. CMN1771, approximately how much did you spend while on your 3-month trip? I'm trying to get an idea of what I can expect to spend if I do that. Well, you know, if you can spend zero almost. If I would have stayed in free campsites, my extra cost would have been approximately around $300 a month. You know, most of that's gasoline, and the other is extra cost for, I had a flat. And, you know, other things, you know, about $300 a month. If you stay in RV parks, just add the cost of the RV park to the $300 and you're good to go. Chip Pryor, we had strong winds in the area. That's probably what caused damage to your cover. Thank you, Chip. It could be. It could just, you know, we get what's called these downbursts every now and then. And, they actually will break limbs off trees. So it could have been that, but I kind of doubt it. But thank you, Chip. Leanne49, welcome back home. You need a cheap lawnmower from your favorite Walmart store? No, I'm not getting a lawnmower. None of that changing oil and putting gas in and all that. No, and noise? No. I like quiet. That's why I want to get a cordless weed eater. And I've already got one on order. Be here Thursday or Friday. Yeah, I like quiet. And I don't want to be hauling gas around. Leanne49, welcome back home. Oh, she said that. You need a cheap lawnmower. Just don't forget the gas can. Yeah, it will give you exercise and keep snakes away. Knock on wood, I don't think I've seen two or three snakes around here, and none of them were poisonous. You know, we have copperheads in the area. I haven't seen any. I'm sure we've got rattlesnakes too, but I haven't seen any. In 14 years, I guess, in that range. Julia Russell, you going back home makes me think of the trash can Matilda that is still missing. Yeah, Matilda's gone. Matilda ran off with the garbage men. Oh, can't trust that old hussy. Desiree LaMarche, is that your own land or is that a lot you rent? I own it. There's several lots here. Bob Arbo, way to go. Thank you. Drifty Grandma Mary. appreciate your video as I try to decide on best type RV for me to full-time considering my budget. Glad you made it home safe and happy. Yeah, you know, that's a tough choice. You know, when you start looking at RVs, we're going to do a few more, and then I'll do about four more here. And anyway, B&L Empty Nesters. Hey, hi, Rusty. I changed my name to B&L Empty Nesters. Bruce and Laura, I thought I was going to hunt and fish more when our kids left. LOL. Please check out my channel of me riding around Northeast Maine. Thank you, Rusty. Okay, B&L Empty Nesters. Amy Mosley Smith. Dear Rusty, we have to allow you to be a little late if you need to be with putting out videos. Glad you're safe and sound. I was a little worried. No, it wasn't me. I posted the video. I mean, I started uploading it yesterday morning just like I normally do, and it didn't pop up till late yesterday evening. I mean, I checked it several times. It says loading, 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 but it was just, I don't know what happened. This is GR Gerace 007, I guess. Love you, Rusty. Watch you every day. I've been a full-timer for 5 years. Four in a Holiday Rambler 29-foot and recently in a 28-foot bumper pull. Home base for me is outside Austin and Bastrop. Well, good for you. I know where that is. We've got a half dozen friends up by you in Marble Falls and Burnett area. Maybe we'll be up. We'll bump in one day. Carpe diem, deep breath, stretch, and do not let negative net in your head. That's absolutely right. We got two more and we'll shut her down. Roger St. Martin, when you were trying to get that mosquito, I thought you were going to belt out. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Yeah, remember that kids song? Yeah, it was good. Thank you, Roger. Last one here, Mabel Lane. You should plan on visiting Great Smoky Mountains. It's a beautiful place. You'd love it. I don't go east of the Mississippi, guys. I really don't. I've been out there a few times, and it's too crowded for old dad. But anyway, guys, hey, Google, tell us a joke.
Why did the honest baker go out of business? She refused to sugarcoat.
That's so bad, so bad, so bad. So bad. Anyway, but anyway, guys, from Central Texas, USA, this is Rusty 78609 saying thumbs up, carpe diem, adios, bye-bye, buy anything you want. But if you think about it, use the Amazon link in the description of my videos. I certainly appreciate it. And what else? It doesn't cost you a penny. It's a free ride. What else? Drink 3 or 4 quarts a day of water per day. Why? Because that'll help you avoid gout, kidney stones, and it will also help you lose weight because you'll be full of water. What else? Take deep breaths. Breathe in deep, breathe out slowly. Why? Because that reduces stress, and reducing stress lowers your blood pressure. And is that good for you? Yeah, sure it is. Everybody knows that. And then stretch, 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 walk, 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 and keep your health. You know what I mean? Keep your body busy. And then stand guard at the door of your mind, because it's yours, number one. And don't let negative Nancy or negative Ned inside your head. Don't let them dump their trash right in here. And the talking heads too. I mean, I'm a talking head, but you know what I mean. Talking about the news media primarily and some of the TV shows, but that's your choice. You do whatever you feel, whatever you want to do, but then be willing to pay the price, okay? What else? That's it, guys. Just take it one day at a time. Don't get in a hurry. That's, you know, that's kind of the way I do. I constantly remind myself, slow down, Rusty. You don't need in a hurry. Everything's okay. Because if you're in a hurry, you're just hurrying to the last moment on earth, okay? And I ain't in no hurry to get there, okay? So anyway, guys, enjoy your day. Adios. Bye-bye.